Welcome back, everyone, to theCUBE's live coverage of AWS reInvent 2025. I'm John Furrier, host of theCUBE. This is our 13th year of reInvent. We've seen the evolution of AWS Cloud as they abstracted away servers and complexity around infrastructure. Now they're abstracting away the data and the work with agents. A new agentic era is upon us. A lot of great use cases emerge. The power of the cloud, the power of AI and data really driving. In this segment, we have a great use case of the World Surf League, who is using data in a really clever way. Julia Chen, VP of AWS Partner Core. Welcome to theCUBE.
Thank you so much.
Good to see you. This is your partner. It's a great story. I want to get into it. Robert, you're the CTO of the World Surf League, which I have FOMO. I wish I could be in that league. Gabriel, you're the CMO of AllCloud, partnering up with the World Surf League. This is like a really killer use case of, it's fun, it's sporty, but it's also hardcore big data going on in an area that didn't have it. All my friends have the Garmin watches when they go kite surfing. Everyone's got the wearables. Take us through the situation. What are you guys doing? Where's the innovation? Take us through the innovation here.
Sure. It started in 2020 when we identified that we could close a gap that existed in competitive surfing for the athletes by building an app that lived on an Apple Watch and gave them real-time information about the heat that they're in. And we thought it would launch pretty quickly, and like these things go, it took a couple years to get it exactly right. But we launched it at the beginning of 2023, where every surfer in our championship tour wore an Apple Watch during their heat, and we're getting a real-time scoreboard of information during the heat. You have to think about the fact that they're a couple hundred yards offshore, and it's windy and sunny, and so it's really hard to get that scoring information and the heat clock and everything from the beach, and now they have it on their wrist.
Versus the old way, they're in the tower, binoculars on, they're looking at everything.
There's LED boards, and they're asking someone on the beach, talking through a megaphone to give them the information, right? Like that situation. So we launched that in 2023, and it went really well. The surfers embraced it. But then we asked, what else can we do with this? They're all wearing these wearables. And that's really the story we're telling today, which is we started collecting all the data we could off the watches. And then through our partnership with AllCloud and AWS, went through the process of building a pipeline that processes all of that data, correlates that data with our scoring and judging information, and really creates sort of a finished product data that we can show to athletes, to fans, et cetera. And I'm really looking forward to the start of our 2026 season when we're going to
So this year, so 2026, you're going to start rendering the data for broadcast, digital?
In broadcast, in digital. I mean, most of our broadcasts are on digital.
On streaming,
And then we're going to run a project to work with the athletes and deliver performance data to them so they can get better, too.
You were mentioning before we were on camera about how golf has that tracing and you can see where all the balls went. Similar thing here with what you're getting now. So you're getting all the instrumentation off the speed. Take us through with some of the key stats you're getting now with the capture.
I think the key ones that stand out that didn't exist for surfing prior to this project are miles per hour, distance surfed, a correlation of those with heart rate. So when Barron took off, his heart rate was 181. And our ability to correlate those back to the actual scoring data about the heat. So show me everybody that got an eight and what their heart rate was or where they took off. It's really data that didn't exist, and it could fundamentally change the way we understand the sport. Yeah. And then the pathing data that you're talking about is also available. That's much harder to productize, right? It's so much coordinate data, but we'll get there.
So all the athletes these days, my observation, they're all kind of nerds. You know, stats and football, it's like they play the probabilities and all. They look at the data. Is there learnings coming out from the athletes? Because they're early adopters. They'll take any edge. What's the what are they using the data for? What have been some of the observations on the learnings that they're taking in for their training or technique?
So the first thing I would say is this project, they've been involved every step of the way. every piece of testing, every UI I've shown to athletes and gotten their feedback. And this process data will be no different. So after each event in the early part of 2026, I'll be working with a small group of athletes. We'll look at the data that's coming out of the system, and we're going to cherry pick what's useful for them and their coaches, and then build a system to deliver that data at the end of each competition.
You guys track like the wipeouts and like the pressure and like all that?
That's a great question, because one of the big challenges here is the anomaly detection. Yeah. Are they on the board? When did they fall off, right? And that's really where AWS and AllCloud kind of come into the picture in part. The ability to kind of look at those data points and say, oh, that person's on a jet ski, they're not actually surfing, is really important part of this, right? Yeah. Like, we have to be confident that if I'm showing you this person went 28.9 miles per hour, that that's actually what they did, right? So yes, we can tell if you wiped out. We probably are not going to show that, but
it's good from a safety standpoint. I mean, Julie, in the NFL, I remember when Andy was on stage with Roger Goodell a couple bunch of reinvents ago, and you know, one of the main partnerships that they did with AWS was for safety.
Yes,
with all the instrumentation. Of course, we see it on TV all the time, and how this they have all the probabilities. How does this tie together with AllCloud on the implementation? Take us through the AWS cloud piece. Okay, he's got the data, he's got the surfers.
Yes. Actually, we should, that's more of a your question.
Sure,
right?
Sure. Yes, yeah, so, I mean, part of it is, when we first started working with World Surf League, I think the team got really excited because they learned very quickly that this is not a data migration project. This is transformational. It has the possibility to be transformational for somebody. So they got really excited. And our team specializes in AI-led professional managed services. We've been doing so for years. So they're no stranger to having to use AI on AWS to come up with a new business challenge. So for World Surf League, as Robert mentioned, we used a number of technologies. We used Kinesis to pull the data from the wearables. We built a centralized analytics layer on Redshift, which enabled high-speed queries of things like the biometrics, like the scoring, for example. And then on Bedrock, we actually built a solution that is integrated with the structured data on Redshift, right? And so that's what allows the broadcasters to come in and say, okay, pretty instantaneously, they can get access to their queries, to this information, so that they can then form that narrative to the end viewer and get that information out to them quickly. So I think that was really one of the game changers, because they had the brilliant idea of using wearables and to pull this in.
Got it. And on the technical side, now that you have the partner, what's your linkage with the cloud? How do you guys interface with that?
With AllCloud?
AllCloud, yeah.
I mean, we've worked with them pretty consistently over the last 18 months, and it's a very collaborative partnership. It's not, you know, here, give me an RFP, RFP. It's more, what is the right next thing to do? And they have an opinion, and we have an opinion, and both of us are contributing to that. So, yeah.
So they've been from day one, the ground floor.
I mean, for the process data part, yes, okay. Absolutely.
What's been the big challenge that you've seen, that you guys overcame? What was the one thing that you, or were there a few that, because this is really a progressive project. It's not obvious.
Right.
I mean,
right.
You look at, I'm sure when everyone sees it on TV, it's like, okay, I get it. It's a great experience for the fans and the viewers. But it's not obvious, but then it is kind of obvious.
There's lots of little things, I would say, is the right answer to that question, not one big one.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's little things like the data coming off the watches has one timestamp. The data coming out of our scoring system has a different timestamp. The events are in 12 different time zones. Building a robust system that can process all the data and recognize all of those timestamps, deliver data that's in sync, is a non-trivial task. It really is. And that part of the project was a bit maddening. What time zone is this event in? Oh, it was daylight savings. Like, there's lots of details under the covers. And, you know, there it's like, you know, our collaboration with AllCloud and with AWS, like there are, you know, basic technology components there that make things like that easier. And now that it's all working, like the scoring data is pouring in, the watch data comes in at the end of each heat. We can talk about that if you want.
Yeah, let's definitely talk about it.
And they're together and we can correlate, you know, this person surfed 6 waves and here's what the scores look like and the heart rates and miles per hour.
Like I said, the analytics drive a lot of it. Has there been any movement in the sport on scoring based upon the new data? Are the servers saying, hey, we should incorporate, they'll probably have some biases.
I think that's one area where we're particularly conservative because we are a judged sport. I don't think it's out of the question that we'll end up there at some point. But I think the places where we're starting are, you know, to your earlier point, fan engagement and athlete performance. Mm-hmm. And we certainly will give the judges access to this data. But I think we need to be very careful and conservative where judging is concerned.
Julia, talk about the on your side. Obviously, it's a great use case.
Yes.
Great marketing opportunity,
too.
Oh, my
goodness. It's awesome.
So talk about how the partners, this is, again, part of the partner network, is a great use case.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, we love this. So first of all, when I heard I was going to get to do this segment, I was so excited. I'm a very, very, very amateur surfer, but a huge fan. And I think for me, it's one of those, like, it's exactly what we love to talk about, which is, what is the customer, like, work back from the customer and the athlete in this case and the fans, right? So how do you bring this alive? So certainly from AWS, we've got Bedrock announcements and amazing things that are coming out, Agent Core, all these things. And I'm excited because all these new use cases that you guys are talking about will be enabled by Create an Agent, right? Now that the migration and the modernization have happened with AllCloud, like we were able to move that stuff off of Excel files, off of wherever it was before. Yes. Now that it's in one place, you can put all the agents and all the agentic capability on top of it and, you know, the sky's the limit or the ocean's the limit, however you want to put it, right? So it's really awesome. So as someone who works with partners day in and day out, like this is an amazing, you know, story to be able to tell, which is to say, take this sport that historically has been, we were talking earlier, harder to access from a fan perspective, right? So again, I love surfing, but my experience of watching surfers is I have to sit on the beach and I have to, you know, with the binoculars. And now it's changing the game because it's like you can view it and see all the stats and all the things and get excited and really like study it like you would some of these other sports that people watch in a stadium.
And of course, I would admit I'm a fan of Instagram reels that have all the big surf. And of course, Mavericks is in California, big surf race. On the partner side, what incentives, talk about the partner side of Amazon. How are they helping you? Because this is an ambitious project. It's transformative.
It is. And I don't know if we mentioned this, but I believe you're collecting 100 data points per second. Yep. Is that correct? For thousands of waves around the globe, right? And so you're absolutely right. It's an ambitious project. But that's part of the reason why we're so excited about it, I think. Yeah. We pride ourselves on the fact that we're an all-in AWS partner.
Yay. Thank you.
Sure. And like I said earlier, we specialize in AI-led professional managed services. So we're one of the first groups to have a dedicated AI team globally as an SI. And so as part of that, we have all the certifications and the badges and everything else to showcase our expertise. But it becomes kind of institutional knowledge in how to work with the AWS team on some things like this. We've done a lot of interesting, innovative projects using AI on AWS, but this one is really special, like I said. So yes, we use some of the programs. Yeah. It's not just some of the standard programs that you get access to, but knowing what teams to work with, knowing who to call in when we need a little bit deeper knowledge, right?
And now you got the Kiro agent, you got the DevOps agent.
Oh, yeah.
Exactly. You can have your own engineer on call now.
Right, exactly. And then, of course, there's also programs that we get access to as a top partner with AWS. Yeah. So that really helps as we want to move quickly because this was a very fast-moving project at the end as well.
Great.
And so I think that institutional knowledge just kind of helps us move things along for the partner.
Yeah, it's a great example of real-life story sports in surfing. Again, like I said, it's a great solution for the fan. I want to ask about the athletes. What's been some of the commentary, Robert, from the athletes? Obviously, they're enthusiastic. Are they totally into it? Share some of the stories around the athletes' vibe on this.
I think what we all know about professional athletes is they will take anything that makes them better, gives them an advantage, right? And I think this is no different. I think it's very early days in terms of us giving them access. So I don't have a particular anecdote for the data part of it, but for the watch part of it, we've had athletes win heats when they thought they were ahead and then realized they were behind because they looked at their watch and took a wave.
Yeah.
And
so they made real-time decision making.
Correct.
Based upon the data.
Yeah, I say to my team, in the water.
Yeah.
I say to my team all the time, they're out there making $100,000 decisions with this software, so it has to be as good as we could possibly make it.
Yeah, they can make good decision making. Talk about the broadcast. I know you've got plans this year. Is there any thinking around how you're going to look at that? Has there been any kind of like tests? Have you guys done mock-ups, doing some R&D on this? What's the view on how you're thinking about the broadcast experience?
I'm laughing a little bit because we've literally the last 2 weeks have been meetings with mock-ups, my team working with our broadcast team to figure out how this is going to play out on broadcast. I think it's interesting to watch it progress. Like the first mock-ups were too information dense, and it's got to be digestible in the moment, and our talent needs to be able to talk to it too, right? So there's a few different things in play there, and it's also got to be contextual, right? It's got to make sense for the moment in the event or heat. So there's definitely things to learn there. Live sports and live sports broadcasting is
the integration and the screen alone is a challenge, and graphics. But it's a big data opportunity. I mean, we see the NFL, Julia, done on like things like probability of this wave will get, you know, he'll make this wave. You have all kinds of historical, as you get more corpus of data, you can get more action.
I know, it's super, I mean, it's so interesting. Even the physics of the waves, the shape of the waves, right, the speed of the waves, like all that kind of stuff, it's so interesting.
I really do want to do that win probability thing that you just alluded to. Like, it's already on my list. I'm real enthusiastic about it, but that's another one where I think you've got to have a really robust data model and a corpus of data. I'm sure with some of the new tools that AWS is.
I mean, I can imagine computer vision. I just interviewed the Just Walk Out team, and you can have computer vision augment the watch potentially with cameras. I mean, it's like physical AI is coming fast.
Yes.
I think that might be, I mean, it's so much fun to talk about because you're just setting the groundwork for the sport.
Right, right.
And that translates into fan experience, digital, social.
I mean, I think the great thing about this year's project is it really lays the foundation for those future pieces, right? Like in the world pre this project, all the data was in different places, et cetera. And now if we do want to add computer vision, it can go in Redshift and it can go into the pipeline. And like I think we've really set ourselves up in conjunction with our partners.
For Gabriel, the future, we get to tap on the AWS. I need some of that computer vision.
I'm loving it.
Just surf out.
Just surf out.
Now, there's some, I mean, the technology, if you look at like some of the cutting edge computer vision, whether it's used for, you know, crime detection or other things, they can actually look at the surrounding area, ingest that in real time, and stitch that together with the wearable.
Yeah.
I mean, that's possible. Well, thanks so much for coming on. Julie, great to see you. Thanks for sharing the use case. It's super, super cool environment. Again, I know all my surfer friends all love the wearables because it's like they want the stats. How far did I go? How's my heartbeat? So they're into it. So good call. Thanks for coming on. Appreciate
it. Thanks for having
us. Thank you for having us.
I'm John Furrier at theCUBE here at reInvent Live. More coverage after this short break.